You don't eat meat, do you? Just the other day, I had a fascinating interaction with a cougar who communicated to me in no uncertain terms that she wished she could just live off fruits and seeds. Imagine peeking around a bush and catching a cougar with a mouthful of blueberries. She doesn't have a choice, but we do, which means we have a responsibility. You know that. That's not why you're here. You're here because we have work to do. Some poachers have made camp close by. If we can strike back, teach them a lesson, maybe reduce some of this mindless killing.
Thank you.
I've been meaning to tell you. I've made a new friend, a fox. Oh, so often a fox. I know I'm not the easiest woman to get along with, but this animal, well, do you know what it's like to be seen? To feel accepted without reservation for who you are. And now I'm just terrified that they, a cabal of skin hunters, have set up camp nearby. They'll wipe out the whole region if they aren't stopped, including my Francis. You'll drop in on them, won't you? You are very convincing.
Thank you.
Listen to this. Do you know what that means? My name is Harriet. Isn't that wonderful? To think all those years I wasted learning French when I could have been out here. Ah, we must push on with our research. So, there's a bison I've been hearing about. A formidable specimen, if the rumors are true. I'd very much like to study its physiology, if you can get me a sample. Doesn't this make you feel good? Hunting humanely in the name of science. It really does.
I'd steer clear of the valley if I were you. Some big hunt going on down there. Can't move or flying lead and stampeding buffalo. Not worth getting tangled up in, if you ask me.
Whoa!